हेलो लिसनर्स, वेलकम टू अनदर पॉडकास्ट बाय एमएसटी रिव्यू सीरीज। मेरा नाम राधिका है एंड टुडे आई एम वेरी एक्साइटेड टू ब्रिंग टू यू द रिव्यू ऑफ अ वेरी फेमस एंड अ वेरी कूल मूवी आई है। सो इसके लिए सबसे पहले लेट्स वेलकम ऑन बोर्ड मिस सलोनी। सो हाय सलोनी, थैंक यू फॉर बीइंग हियर।
थैंक्स राधिका, थैंक्स फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी।
आई एम सो ग्लैड दैट यू आर अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस। सो आई थिंक सलोनी, सबसे पहले आवर लिसनर्स वुड लाइक टू नो यू अ लिटिल बिट। You know, so would you like to tell us ki aapki journey kya hai, aap kahan se aate ho, you know, a little bit about you so that we can connect to you better?
Yes, of course. So, my name is Saloni. I'm from Nashik, Maharashtra. Most people would probably know Nashik because of Sula.
Correct.
So even though I'm from Nashik, I've actually moved around quite a bit. Growing up, I was living in UAE. Then after that, I moved back to Nashik, then to Bombay for college. Then I did a brief fellowship for about 2 years in Surat, and then back to Bombay, and then now I'm based out of Delhi.
Right.
So, yeah, I mean, now I'm working with an education-based organization in their partnerships and donors team.
Okay. I think that's a lot of traveling for you.
It is.
It's been, really, how did you adjust? You know, what happened? How did you, you know, make friends?
Honestly, it's not easy. It's really not. I've been lucky in Delhi that I ended up meeting friends who were already friends from back in the fellowship, but Bombay was a bit difficult.
Right.
It's very hard to actually make friends as you grow older is what I've realized.
Right.
It was very strange learning. I didn't expect that it would be so difficult. And like the harder I tried to actually fit in, it just became a lot harder to actually become friends with anybody.
Definitely. So, I think that's a struggle that all of us go through.
Yeah. And funnily enough, it just seems to get harder and harder now. I don't know how.
So did this movie help you in some way?
So I think first, yes, Silver Linings Playbook is a really, really nice movie. It's actually one of my favorites.
Right.
It helped in that I realized that, I mean, everybody is equally weird. I mean, if you look at the movie, if you look at your, and if you compare it to people in your life, you realize everybody is weird. And
right.
Everybody tries to be really normal and tries to be all, oh hey, you know, we're really good, we're all great, we've got our lives together, but at the end of it you'll see that it's not the case, and you know that honestly makes it a lot more easier for you to just be more relaxed about trying to fit in. Because you realize ki matlab itna zyada zarurat nahi hai karne ka, itna jo stress lete ho, itna effort jo karna padta, you don't need to. I think what would also help to sort of give a context to those who have not seen the movie yet. I'm guessing there must be a lot of people like that.
Right.
So essentially, this is Silver Linings Playbook is based on a book of the same name. Rajiv, correct me if I'm wrong.
That's right.
So the idea is that there's this person who's been in a rehabilitation center for the past 8 months. Because of a severe anger incident that took place, as soon as he's discharged, he has to sort of try and bring his back life to normal, because he believes that if he has his things in order, his ex-wife would be willing to accept him and take him back, and they would be back together and be happy again. And the story is all about how he tries really hard for that, but in that process just has to go through a whole lot of other things which are surprisingly more in alignment with what he is as a person. For example, he ends up meeting this other woman, and you know, they become friends because she promises to reach out to his wife on his behalf. And you know, they start working together because she wants to participate in a dance competition. He has to manage his family because they're really happy to be that he's home, but they're also really scared of him because of the incident that happened, wherein he punched somebody for having an affair with, and punched him almost to death for having an affair with his wife. So the entire movie captures how he, you know, goes through this entire phase of his life while trying to figure out how he's supposed to be, how he can be the perfect husband, the perfect, with the perfect, you know, skills, with the perfect kind of, with just the perfect body, and how he's striving really hard to be accepted by his wife, but at the same time he also has to deal with the craziness that's there in his family, which they try to keep hidden but is obviously not.
Right.
So, I mean, yeah, and it's just a really, really nice movie, as in you don't even feel like at any point you're going to, you know, I don't know. I think I'm losing track now. Tell me. So you had more questions, I suppose.
Yes, I did. I just got lost and, you know, how you were putting it out. So there were so many points that you came up with, you know, his struggle to accept his anger issues, then
yeah.
making new friends, as we said, at, you know, let's say when you're about above 25, then, you know, understanding your own issues and then relating it to your family, you know, taking in consideration their anger towards you, their scared, the fear towards you, the wife, the pair. You know, so there's like so much that is happening, and also you mentioned something about a dance competition that the girl wants to go for and stuff. So also handling all of this and still wanting to, you know, fulfill your dreams and go for your aspirations. There's a lot that is, you know, happening in this book, in the movie.
Yes, there is. I'm sorry I lost the thread of the synopsis somewhere in the middle, but I'm hoping it, I don't know, at least gives enough of an incentive to the listeners to actually want to pay, you know, want to watch it.
Definitely.
So one of the things that that is really striking in this movie is the way that they have actually addressed a lot of disorders that happen. So for example, the lead character has bipolar. The woman that he becomes friends with has this obsessive need to have sex with people. They have this friend who's a recurring character who has ADD, who's been addicted to drugs, and you know, it's not been a good combination, which obviously resulted in him also lashing out. And the way that they've dealt with all of these, you know, in the movie, wherein some are just direct conversations, which also helps to really normalize it, because otherwise it's a topic that everybody always tiptoes around, right? You don't ever want to directly engage with a person who has bipolar and say, hey, I know you have bipolar. Can you tell me what's there? Can you tell me what's up with that?
Right.
You always want to just avoid it.
Definitely.
Or you want to be like, okay, I know this person has it, so let's never directly reference to it, but let's be really careful. And you cease to treat them as another person in that process.
Definitely.
I mean, so even in the movie, you see that happening a lot, where you see the mom really struggling to deal with it, the father just thinking, acha theek hai, ho jayega, we'll manage. And you know, and thinking, okay, you know what, if he's out, he's out, but that doesn't mean that he's going to do anything severe. So yeah, I mean, there's a lot that is happening in this movie that way.
I also feel that, you know, you've been able to understand a lot more about these disorders that you said. So was that a case there? Were you able to, you know, gain a little bit more insight about what bipolar is, what the repressed sexual drive is, what ADD is?
A little bit in that. So I could understand a few of the symptoms because they also showed those out in the movie. But I'd be a little hesitant to say that I've understood a lot more about it. I think it would still differ person to person. Again, correct me if I'm wrong. This is my
Definitely.
But so, what I also realized was that a lot of the things that they said didn't sound, or I couldn't really entirely associate them with their particular disorder either. I mean, there's a section where, you know, they're having a conversation in the diner and she's describing to him all the things that she did, all the sexual encounters she had with people in office, and he's trying to understand more because he wants to. And, you know, And then he's quick to judge her for it as well. But if you think about it, and if you look at it very objectively, I mean, it's a conversation I probably would want to have with somebody, and I probably want to know more about. You know, it doesn't mean that they're crazy or something like that. And that's what you can see in the movie as well. You know, a bunch of people being defined as crazy who may not really just be that crazy.
Right.
I mean, of course, they have their own struggles, and they have them in more extreme situations than most people, but that doesn't define them as crazy.
Right. Definitely. I think that is there for almost all, you know, hashtag misunderstood disorders and the misunderstood realm of mental health.
Yeah.
So many times we ourselves also think that, you know, these are things that we'll never be able to get out of, and
yeah,
there will, you know, be no help or rescue for us. But actually there is. And I feel with movies like this and, you know, with books of similar kinds, people are really getting out there and trying to break the stigma around all of these things.
Yeah.
So definitely, I'm so glad that you were able to associate with all of these things, you know, understand that just being labeled as crazy is not enough. There is a lot more that is riding towards it.
Yeah.
Right.
And so,
yeah. So, you know, I think we've come to the end of the podcast. And is there a, you know, parting note or a recommendation that you want to give to our listeners?
So this it's not exactly a recommendation for a movie or a book, but I think it's just a recommendation that I'd give based on a conversation I had with somebody a long time ago as well.
Yeah.
Is that I think at some point or the other, we all sort of need help, and it's just that we're often too scared to take it.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, giving mental health a priority, providing mental health as a priority in your life is something that I think we should all strive towards, because even from personal experience, I can say that prioritizing it has helped me. And I think a lot of us need it, and we're just too scared to admit it, or we're too scared to even recognize that there's a need for it. So, to anybody who's listening, please do prioritize your mental health. Please do prioritize your health and yourself in itself.
Definitely. I feel no wiser words have been said. I vehemently agree with the whole concept. You know, there are certain times when you feel that you are not, you know, being able to give yourself the complete time, and you're not being able to, you know, give yourself what you deserve. And these are those times when you have to really push yourself towards keeping yourself as a priority, and maybe, you know, just being able to give yourself what you need.
Yeah.
So definitely, readers and listeners, this was it from us for the review of Silver Linings Playbook, and thank you so much, Saloni, for coming and talking to us about it.
Thank you for inviting me. I hope that people watch this movie. It's a great watch.
Definitely, we hope so too. And until then, if you have any comments or you want to add to the review series, or if there are any other movies or books or letters or poems or, you know, web series that you want us to review, please do message on the comments below, or on our email, or on our Instagram page, and we will definitely try to review the same. Until then, this is me, Rajika, signing off, and thank you for tuning in.